so cool.
Pittsburgh and steel. The two have shared a love affair for generations. But tonight, I want you to meet a modern-day marvel. He's a young guy with an old-fashioned love, and what he does with it is timeless. He plays with fire and cuts through steel.
It's pretty cool. This does most of the work.
Lighting up history and changing its course.
I think these look best with a quarter twist on them.
Yeah, I grew up a little bit north of the city.
Collin Carrier is a 21st century blacksmith whose 18th century love makes hammering horseshoes seem almost elementary.
Being able to heat up something, you know, 2 inches in diameter and just bend different shapes out of it.
He schooled in sculpture, but something hotter burned Collin's heart.
I like it because it's quiet.
A blacksmith in Virginia planted the seed, and it grew.
Stuck a brick drum on top of a pile of bricks, took a shop vac, put it on blow and some charcoal from the grill, you know.
Collin made his own forge, got his hands on some metal, and went old school.
Just takes a second to cycle up.
Buying a multi-ton machine so serious, he had to pour 4 feet of concrete into the floor below it just to hold the thing in place.
Some of these are old tools, you know, could be 100 years old. A lot of them are ones that I made just recently.
In a matter of months, one job grew into 4, an overhang for Bike Pittsburgh.
Threw a couple designs at them.
Magnificent fireplace screens, you know, with details almost sweet. Each flower, every leaf, each smoothed, tapered table leg, crafted by hand. Small works from this belt buckle made from the iron of a 100-year-old fence to this spectacular gate in Lawrenceville. Look at that thing. Even these door handles at Mad Max. Collin proves with each spark and every strike that steel really can get into your blood.